we are asked what number is represented by the blocks shown. So we could sit and count all of these, but let's think about this a little bit more constructively. So how many blocks do we have in one of these squares here? Well, let's see, it's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this is a 10 by 10 square. It's going to have 100 blocks. So this is 100, this is another 100. So we have 200s. So 200 blocks from these two. And then let's count these right over here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 in each of these rows. And we have 4 of these rows. So 4 times 10, that's 40. So we have 200 and then 40. 240 blocks. Let's check our answer. Now you might be saying, what's the whole point of this exercise? Isn't this just an exercise in counting blocks? But you might notice something interesting happening here. When I wrote this 2 here, it's making you appreciate that 2 doesn't just represent 2, it's in the hundreds place. So that 2 is actually representing 200. It's representing both of these squares of blocks right over here. This 4 doesn't just represent 4, it's in the tens place. So it actually represents 40. It's representing these 4 groups of 10. This is these 2 groups of 100. This is these 4 groups of 10. Let's do another one. Oh, this is interesting. So let's do the hundreds first. So we have one group of 100 right over there. So it's going to be 100. And then let's see, we have 5 groups of 10. So 150, and then we just have 4 blocks. So we just have that 4 there. So let's check, make sure we got it right. And you see that this 4, that's in the ones place. So it literally represents 4 blocks. This 5, that's in the tens place. So it's literally representing 5 groups of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this 1 is in the hundreds place. It literally represents one group of 100, this big square right over here.